while ago, Espressif Systems announced the release of ESP Privilege Separation, which is a framework that creates two isolated execution environments, the user application and the kernel or privileged application. This framework boosts security by preventing user applications from interfering with protected applications. This way, if there are any bugs, they will not affect the entire system. In this video, we will demonstrate an example of how you can update the user application in the ESP Privilege Separation framework. For this example, we have built an ESP RainMaker application on top of the ESP Privilege Separation framework. Here, RainMaker services are protected in the privileged application, while the user application configures the device by using the RainMaker services. So, on the right, I have the ESP RainMaker mobile app running on my phone. On the left, I have the RMaker switch example, which is built on top of the ESP Privilege Separation framework. This example is available on our GitHub repo, so you can try it yourselves. The user application in this particular example uses the RainMaker services in the protected app in order to configure the device as a switch that can be controlled remotely through the RainMaker app. The application is already flashed, so we can open the console monitor straight away. As you can see from the logs, the device has been connected to the Wi-Fi and is now attempting a connection with the RainMaker cloud. Once the connection is established, we will be able to see our device online in the mobile app. I can also turn the device itself on and off from the app, which can be observed on the console as well. We have prepared another user application that configures the device as a light bulb with various colors and brightness controls. So, to update the user application, I will put user OTA on the command line interface and will then add the URL of the user application. As soon as I hit enter, the protected application verifies the URL and establishes a connection with it. Then, the user application is being downloaded and verified. The size of the new user application is around 110 kilobytes only, as is highlighted in the console. Once the update is successful, the device reboots and starts executing the new user application. Now, if I refresh the mobile app, you can see that my device, which was previously configured as a switch, is now configured as a light bulb, which I can turn on and off. I can also change the brightness and hue of the bulb from the mobile app. Therefore, with this example, you can see how the ESP Privilege Separation framework enables over-the-air updates of the user application. By just updating the user application, which was 110 kilobytes, we were able to transform the identity of the device as we changed it from a switch into a light bulb. In a traditional ESP RainMaker example, such an update would take a few megabytes. To get all the details about the ESP Privilege Separation framework and ESP RainMaker, please visit the links provided in the description of this video. Thanks for watching.